Space Marine scouts operate deep behind enemy lines, sowing disruption and capturing key objectives for their chapter. In this video, we're going to show exactly how to paint the Space Marine scouts of the glorious Ultramarines chapter up to battle-ready standard using the contrast painting method. Now, to prepare our mold for painting, we've already undercoated it with Grey Sear. We've actually used a spray here to make the process a little quicker and easier, but you can use the paint out of a pot if you'd like to. Once the undercoat has dried, it's time to move on to the contrast painting stage. And naturally, the first one we're going to use for an ultramarine is Ultramarines Blue. So grab yourself your medium shade brush and let's get to it. So we're going to take a little bit of paint out of the pot like this and just onto our palette. The reason we're doing this is we're making sure we're not overloading our brush with too much paint. There we go, that's perfect. Then onto our miniature, we're just going to apply it onto all of the blue areas of our Space Marine Scout, so anywhere where he's got armor. If you're a bit confused about exactly which areas want to be blue, have a look at the box art or pictures on the website and that will help you out. Now as you're applying your contrast paint, you want to apply it quite thickly onto the model like this. But as the paint's drying, make sure you're just checking to make sure it's not gathering together in areas or pooling, because that won't look very good when it's dry. Once you've placed it on, you want to leave about 10 minutes for it to fully dry. And once it's done, we'll get on to the next stage. And there you can see the Ultramarines Blue contrast paint has dried on the armor, giving this really cool effect. You can also see we've been a little bit messy here, actually going on to lots of different areas that aren't actually going to be armor. So the next stage is we're going to sort that out by going over those areas again with a bit of Grey Sear out of a pot. For this, we're going to use our medium layer brush. We'll take a little bit of Grey Sear out of the pot like so and onto our palette. Here, we're just going to water it down with a touch of water from our pot. Then onto the miniature, we're going to go over all those areas we've just hit with the blue accidentally. So here on the leg, you can see it's going to tidy up those areas with the Grey Sear. Once you've done this, we'll be ready for the next stage. So there we go, we've tidied up the model here with a Grey Sear base coat. You can see any area that's not meant to be blue, we've repainted it with Grey Sear to make sure it's nice and neat. Ready for the next contrast paints. And the next contrast paint we're going to use is Skeleton Horde, which we're going to apply onto our scout's clothes, that's his trousers and his shirt. But for this, we're actually going to mix it with a little bit of contrast medium to thin it down to make sure the colour isn't too strong. Here's how we're going to do it. With our medium layer brush, we're going to take a little bit of contrast medium out of the pot like so, and mix it onto our palette like this. There we go, about three brushfuls, perfect. Then we're going to take one brushful of Skeleton Horde and place it onto our palette like this and mix it round. In fact, I'm actually going to give a little bit more contrast medium there just to really thin it down. Perfect. And there we go, and now onto our miniature. We're going to apply this very carefully onto our scout's trousers and shirt. So that's the clothes. Make sure you're getting it all the way around as well, so make sure you're hitting the back of the miniature too. Now, as this has had the medium added to it, it's a bit thinner, so therefore it's going to take a little bit longer to dry. So allow about 10 to 15 minutes for this to fully dry. So there we go, the Skeleton Horde has dried on our scout's clothing, giving this really cool effect. So now that's done, it's time to move on to the rest of our contrast paint. We're going to start off with Basilicanum Grey, which is going to go over all the metal areas. Then we're going to use Black Templar to pick out the black areas, such as the leather, the boots, and the gun casing. We use Gilliman Flesh on the face, Nazdrag Yellow on the gold, and finally Wildwood on the hair. So grab your medium layer brush and let's get on with that Basilicanum Grey. So we're going to take a little bit of paint out the pot like so, and again, just put it onto our palette like this. We're just making sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint. Perfect. Then onto the miniature, we're going to apply Basilicanum Grey onto the metal areas. We're actually going to apply it over the entire gun here. And also, don't forget to pick out areas such as the metal tubes around the neck here, the headdress he's wearing here, the headset he's got on. And if your scout has a big combat knife, make sure you paint that Basilicanum Grey too. Next up, we're painting Black Templar onto all the black areas of the miniature. So the boots, the leather, such as the belt and the pouches, and the gun case. Next up, we're applying Gilliman Flesh onto our scout's face. The next contrast paint is Nazdrag Yellow, which we're painting onto the golden areas of our scout. So check out the skull motifs on the armour, and also the chest eagle, the Aquila, here in the centre. And the last contrast paint is Wildwood, which is going to go onto our scout's hair, and also all over the top of the base. And there we go, with all the contrast paint applied to our scout, he's almost ready for the battlefield. There's only one thing left to do, of course, and that's to apply a textured base to our miniature. Now, for ours, we're going to be using a Grellin Earth to make it look like he's striding through cracks and dry ground. But you can, of course, use whichever of the texture paints you like for your miniature. Now, for a Grellin Earth, we're going to be applying it using our medium base brush. So let's take a little bit of paint out of the pot like so, onto our brush, a nice big scoop, perfect. Then, onto our miniature, we're going to apply it very carefully over the top of our base like this. We want a nice thick coat for a Grellin Earth, So the thicker it is, the bigger the cracks it gives. Once it dries, it's going to be cracking, and we'll be able to see that brown colour underneath, which is why we painted Wildwood on the base earlier on. Be very careful to avoid the model's feet as you're applying it all over the base. Once you have, leave about an hour for it to fully dry, and when that's done, we're going to paint the rim of the base with Steel Legion Drab. And with the Agrellan Earth dry and our base rim painted Steel Legion Drab, our Space Marine Scout is ready to infiltrate behind enemy lines. And that's how you paint Space Marine Scouts of the Ultramarines chapter up to battle-ready standard using the contrast painting method. Couple of things to remember here. First of all, when you're applying your paints, try and be as neat as you possibly can, but don't worry if you make a mistake. You can always go back to the original base paint and reapply it. Second of all, when you're applying the contrast paints, make sure you're moving the paint around with the brush as it dries. You don't want to gather them together and pooling. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting.